everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today I am doing part two of my revision advice kind of series for each of my A-level subjects. So as you can probably see from the title of this video, this one is going to be about A-level chemistry, which is arguably everyone's least favourite subject, which is really sad. I would say I don't want to make this video too long, but let's just face it, it's going to be long anyway, because however much I try, I just waffle too much. So without further ado, let's just get on to the video. So as with my biology video, I'm just gonna start off by talking about my experience with A-level chemistry and things I've realized throughout my AS year. So the first thing I would say is it's definitely a big step up from GCSE. Many people do say that chemistry is the biggest step, and I kind of do agree with that. A-level chemistry is really quite different from GCSE chemistry for numerous reasons. For example, the biggest one would definitely be the understanding of it, because at GCSE you can get away with just learning stuff off by heart, but at A-level you actually need to like understand the concepts that you're being taught, otherwise you're not going to enjoy it, number one. Number two, you're going to find it so ridiculously difficult. So that's one thing. And also I hate the fact that at GCSE they teach you this like basically crap, then you move up to A-level and you realize that what you were taught is just completely, well, I wouldn't say completely wrong, but it's just really, really far from the truth. Atomic structure, and at GCSE you're taught like, oh, electrons are in shells, and then at A-level they bombard you with, oh, there are orbitals and electrons spin and blah blah blah, and that it's just like, why couldn't you just tell me that last year? Because now I get confused between like shells and orbitals and how you can have orbitals in a shell. I think it's easier, but then when you move up to A-level you have to relearn everything in a different way, and it's just, I don't get why they do it, but they do, so that's one thing. The content is obviously not going to be the same as GCSE, but I mean, at GCSE you had like one chapter of organics, and then you move to A-level and half the AS syllabus is organics. There was so much like environmental stuff and like the limestone cycle at GCSE, but then at A-level there's none of that like weird crap, and it's mostly just like actual chemistry. Another thing that I have definitely realised, and this isn't just specific to chemistry, it's for all the A-level subjects, is that there is a heck of a lot to learn. I mean, there is plenty of like specific little things to just get in your head, and you need to know all these different compounds and equations and mechanisms, which you don't know what mechanisms are at this point, but you will, and you will dread them. The year 13 mark as well, altogether, it can be quite overwhelming at times, but I just think it's worth highlighting that. But really, it is kind of the same for most A-levels anyway. This next point really became quite crystal clear very quickly, which is that chemistry is one of those subjects where you are literally going to probably fail for most of the year, and then only towards the end you're gonna pick up your grades. For most of the year, actually, our class average on tests would probably be about a D. Not gonna lie, maybe even an E. At the start, it's really hard to kind of get your head around, but as soon as it clicks, literally, like, you're fine, because you just understand it, you can answer the questions, it's all great. It's just a matter of getting it to just click in your head, and that can sometimes take quite a while, which is why there's that kind of trend. You just got to stick it out, to be honest, and you'll see towards the end of the year that your grades are just gonna be sky high compared to the start of the year. In most cases. With chemistry, it just seems kind of impossible to me to like learn stuff without understanding what you're learning, just because so much of chemistry is based on problem solving, and like they give you a question and you have to relate your knowledge to kind of figure out the answer based on a different chemical than what you're used to. They give you like an IR spectrum, and they give you some like, I don't know, equipment that you can use, and they're like, how would you figure out which one is which? And you have to just apply your knowledge to a new situation to figure it out, and that really requires you to understand that knowledge. They often ask you to explain why something is as it is, and if you haven't grasped the concept, then you can't really explain it, and you can't predict what would happen in a similar situation and that kind of stuff, which is a lot of the questions nowadays because the government hate us. So that's definitely a big thing that I've noticed this year for sure. Now I'm going to move on to general advice and how to cope with A-level chemistry, or AS chemistry, because I haven't done A-level yet, and I'm a bit scared. The first piece of advice that I have for you is know your basics. And this, I feel, is very, very important, because you need to have a really, really good grasp of your GCSE chemistry knowledge. So maybe just do a little bit of review work over the summer before year 12, or if the summer has now run out, then just do a bit at the start of the year to kind of refresh your memory, because otherwise you're going to go back to year 12 and there will be a point where you will literally get a massive just shock of like, oh my god, I can't remember any of this and I just don't know what's going on and I don't understand it. And that's really not a good place to be in. There's just so much stuff to get through that teachers don't have time to keep going back to, like, the basic stuff. These things are the foundations of everything you're going to learn in chemistry. So you may as well actually know these things when you're going into it, because it will help with your understanding. And as we've now established, that is a very key thing. It's only going to get harder, and if you don't know the easy stuff, you're gonna really struggle with the harder stuff. The next thing I'm gonna talk about is really, really an obvious thing. Now, if you've watched enough of my videos, you know I keep going on about this, and it's just because I literally can't stress it enough. It's learn it from the start. Keep on top of it from the beginning of the year, because it is going to pile up fast. With this, as I would usually say, make your notes as you go along, keep reviewing your notes, just read over them. Do practice questions as you go along for each topic. Just keep on top of your chemistry work, because this will save you so much time, so much stress. Just, it will save you. It will save your life. In my school, what was really helpful was that when we had chemistry tests, we had fewer of them, but they were on everything we had ever done. So by the time it got to summer term, you could literally recite the stuff from the start of the year, because you just kept on reading over it for each of the tests. So this just emphasizes the importance of just keeping on revising something, because by the end you are literally going to know it so well that you don't really need to do much revision at all for that subject. So it's just kind of helping your future self out now, which is something that you can do and you have control over, so why not, you know? This next thing is one of my absolute biggest tips for this subject in particular, and that is you need to know how to answer the questions. And I know that I say this about a lot of subjects. In chemistry, it is magnified by like 10,000. You will notice that examiners are really, really picky about what they want to see in your answers, and they want to see certain words or phrases, and if you include those, you are going to pick up so many marks automatically if you know what to write for the questions that come up. And as you go through past papers, you can just see there's like exactly the same question, maybe just slightly different phrasing, and it's the same thing, and the mark scheme says the same exact thing. How you phrase things in the exam is kind of sometimes more important than what you've actually learned, especially for things like the Boltzmann distribution or periodicity. It's the same thing every single damn time, and you just need to get to that point where you know everything that they want from your answer, because they can't possibly take marks off you if you have literally mentioned everything that they want. And lastly, for my advice, this is one of the main subjects that you really need to get your teacher to help you if you are struggling, because chemistry is undeniably hard, and if you're struggling, you probably can't just suddenly understand it by yourself. You've also got to be quite proactive about seeking out your teacher's help. So for example, if you just did a test and you're just not happy with your grade and you don't know how to properly improve and you just need more direct feedback than just going over the answers, go and ask your teacher for help, and they should be more than happy to go over the test with you and just give you personal advice on how you can pick up more marks or tailor your revision to your weak areas and how to make revising these areas more effective. Now I'm going to move on to revision tips and how to make the most of your revision, how to make it effective for chemistry and stuff like that. So the first tip is going to be about definitions, and these are very important in chemistry in particular, because questions which ask you for definitions are sometimes worth a whopping 3 marks. And if learning a simple definition is going to get you 3 marks on an exam, then why would you not do it? There are usually like 2 or 3 questions asking you for definitions, so like be nice to yourself and learn them now, and then just get really super easy marks on the exam, so then you can kind of afford to slip up a bit more on like the harder stuff or like the stuff that you just don't understand for the life of you, because there is stuff like that in chemistry and it's a pain in the bottom. Tip number 2 is going to be something that my teacher said a lot to our class, which was that your answers are nearly there, but they're just not specific enough. So obviously learn the specifics, and in your answers, don't beat around the bush, just state it plainly and be completely succinct, because you are going to lose marks if you're just kind of waffling on. And it's so annoying because chemistry is one of those things where you can know what you're going on about and you can be writing an answer that is all perfectly correct and that is like the right logic, but you can lose the marks because you don't put in a certain word or a certain phrase, and examiners are horrible and the mark schemes are actually really centered around these particular words and phrases that they just want to see you use. So yeah, learn the correct terminology, kids, because it's gonna save you. Revision tip number 3 is going to be to keep going over stuff. And you don't have to just keep reading over your notes, just keep practicing stuff, keep certain things just fresh in your mind. For example, personally, I kept on practicing nomenclature. I can't say that word. I might insert it on the screen if I remember. But basically, I kept on practicing it because I was just absolutely atrocious at it. I found this really cool website, which this is kind of sad, but like it was really cool. And it kind of let you just practice naming compounds that it brought up with like different formulae. And this also applies to more complex topics such as mechanisms. I mean, there's just no easy way around it. You've just got to keep practicing it and keep drawing out the mechanisms until you can literally do it in your sleep. And if you can just learn it off by heart, it's 4 marks like that on the exam. And you will be kicking yourself if you lose a mark because you forgot to draw on an arrow or you forgot to draw on a lone pair of electrons. And it's just like, it's those kind of little things where you lose marks and then it just all adds up. Tip number, I forgot which one this is. Tip number 4, maybe? It's just, for chemistry, flashcards are a really efficient way of revising. It's really easy to kind of separate them out onto both sides of the flashcards. Like on one side, write down, for example, the Haber process. And then on the back, you can write out the equation, the conditions for it, what it makes, why it's important, like why the conditions are as they are, and just anything else you need to know about that one thing. And you can build up a nice pile of these flashcards. And I feel like in that respect, it's a lot easier because chemistry is so bullet pointy, I would say, because in stuff like biology, there are so many random things that you just don't know where to start. Whereas chemistry is just like, there's this, and then there's everything to do with it, and then there's this, and everything to do with it. Tip number 5 is gonna be get all the questions you can get your hands on. Chemistry is one of those subjects like maths where you get good at it through practice. And as I said before, practice is one of the main things that will get you the grade that you want. So just get all the past papers that you can get. I mean, I pestered my chemistry teacher for the 2016 paper 2 for so long, I feel really bad. But I mean, I got it in the end. The questions have slightly changed, I've noticed, from the old past papers. They've become a lot more analytical rather than just regurgitation of your knowledge. But nevertheless, it's like there are still really easy kind of can you remember this questions on the new exams. So it's still worth practicing. Also on Caboodle, there is this bank of multiple choice questions. And I would seriously recommend you practice multiple choice because it is so, I mean, it looks easy, but it's just so difficult. You'd think that when you have 4 choices, it's so much easier, but it's really not. I feel like they definitely anticipate all the mistakes that you could make and then just put all those answers down. And the last tip, tip number 6, is going to be learn the stuff from your required practicals. And this is kind of like a bit of a weird one. Like, you wouldn't expect it. It just kind of popped into my head and I was like, yes. But seriously, do. You do so many, at least we did so many. We did way more than we had to. But do all the like questions that they provide for you and just go over it before your test. Since we don't have EMPAS anymore, it just means that you have all those practical questions in the actual exam. So there is a big chunk of the exam that is practical techniques and based mostly on the practicals that you should have already done slash researched in some cases. So it's really just a case of trying your best for those practicals and just reviewing them, but also go over like general things related to practical chemistry. So stuff like terminology, like resolution and accuracy, precision, and how to improve experiments, how to make them more reliable. So the last part of this video is just going to be kind of talking about, should you take A-level chemistry? And as I said in my last video, I cannot tell you take it or don't take it because it is really your decision, and I'm just here to kind of like inform you of the reality of A-level chemistry. But ultimately, it's for you to decide whether that suits you or not. One of the big factors that should come into your decision is your capacity for understanding chemistry. Now, what I mean by capacity is like not whether you understand chemistry right now, because it maybe is just that you didn't put enough effort into understanding it, but whether you can understand chemistry, because there are just some people that just can't get it. So it's really just thinking about, will I be able to deal with this? And have I struggled way too much with understanding it at GCSE that I couldn't possibly do it at A level? But also, don't get me wrong, like if you absolutely adore chemistry and you just love it and you cannot see yourself not taking it, then take it even if you don't quite understand it, because there are ways around that, and you may even get a very, very, very good grade if you kind of put in more work for that subject. So it just really depends what are the subjects you're doing, how much time you're prepared to devote to doing chemistry, and whether that's something that you want to put yourself through, I guess. Especially with like the support of your teachers and your perseverance, you will get a good grade at the end if you just give it your absolute best shot. And a quick side note, I'm not saying that chemistry is just about understanding it. Like, you can get through chemistry without understanding it and you can still get amazing marks. It's just that it makes it a lot easier and it means that you just don't have to put as much time into it. That's kind of what I'm trying to get at with this whole understanding thing, because I don't want people to get angry at me. And I know that some people say that chemistry is the hardest subject that you can do at A level, and obviously I can't speak for the whole course because I've only done AS or like the first year, but it's honestly not that tragic. Like, when I hear some people talk, it's like, it's really not that bad. It really isn't that bad. I mean, I'm slightly biased just because I love chemistry and it's my absolute favorite subject. But as with anything, if you try hard enough for it, you're going to get where you want to be with it. And the last thing that I wanted to say in this video is the temptation to quit chemistry in the first couple of weeks. And I know at the start of year 12, I was flicking through the textbook and looking at some of the stuff that we were going to do later on in the year. And I was just thinking to myself, I am never going to understand this. And now that I've finished this year, I look back and think it really wasn't that bad. I mean, it wasn't super easy, but it wasn't that bad. And as with anything that's really new to you, you're going to be scared of doing it because that's just kind of how most people are. But don't run away from chemistry is what I'd say. Your teachers will help you through the year and they will make it much easier for you to understand than often the textbook seems. So don't be discouraged that the textbook looks awful or you don't understand chemistry, or like you've done one lesson and you're just like done. Just don't give up, because you can do chemistry, I promise. No, actually I don't. So we have now reached the end of this video. So if you found it helpful or enjoyed it in any way, then do give it a thumbs up. And you can also subscribe to my channel. The button is below this video. It's bright red, you can't miss it. Also, if you want to check out my biology A-level video, I'll have it linked somewhere at some point, so you can just click it. And it'll probably be in the description box as well, so you can go watch that. Just to quickly mention kind of like my schedule for these videos, the next one will be maths, and then lastly I'm going to do Latin. So subscribe if you want to see those videos. And you can also follow me on my social media, especially Twitter, because I go on that way too often. I'm so making this a trend in my videos. But the handles are in the description box below. That's about all I have to say. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!